Welcome to Yellow Brick Road. I'm Jordan. Today, it's time for another psychological analysis. This time, Sam Cedar and his crew. But first, please consider donating to Devin's Journey to Recovery. The GoFundMe link is in the description box. If you got $5 or more laying around, you want to donate to a charity, help someone pay medical bills, you can at Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. I sound a little bit too ad man sounding. But, all right, so we have Sam Cedar here at the Majority Report, and he's going to have a healthy criticism of Jimmy Dore and his appearance on Tucker Carlson. Here we go.
You know what? Let's just do this. I want to do this Jimmy Dore thing first. Because we have, we're gonna go to Dave Feldman, and I think he'll appreciate this.
Oh, it's gonna get bad, guys. This is a pretty long video. It's gonna get bad.
Do you know who Jimmy Dore is?
I do. I'm not entirely as into Jimmy Dore as I think you are, but I do know who he is.
Now,
we're real Dore heads.
Yeah. Now look, we have gone through, you know, sort of the rot within the institution of one element of the Democratic Party. I mean, look, to say the Democrats, you're talking about tens of millions of people.
Yes, and a ton of organizations that are, some of which are not even completely related to one another. Yes.
Exactly.
When Dore says the Democrats, I think he means the actual people in the House and the Senate and all that. The politicians, not the constituents. And also the media, corporate Democrats. I think that's pretty well understood who Jimmy Dore is talking about. But, you know, he might be purposely getting that wrong. Seriously. Not for propaganda purposes, but because Sam has something psychological going on. And it seems quite apparent to me. It might be... Sounds like an intoxication with this word. What's this word? Pride. It might be pride. Seriously, stay with me with this. Let's see if you notice it.
And, you know, when I read Atreos's tweets about this, it just seems like, you know, he is talking about specific groups of people within this institution that is problematic.
Yes.
In the same way that I wouldn't say, like, the U.S. government is horrible. Or governments are horrible because right now of who it's populated with. Mm. Like, there's nothing magical about the shell, the brand, the Democrats. It's not necessarily good or bad. You know, it depends on who you're talking to in any given time. There's been time.
By the way, he'd get body slammed if he had to talk to me. He'd get body slammed, people's elbowed, stone cold stunnered. And Michael Brooks would have to jump into the ring, throw in the towel, and pick his teeth up. Just saying, verbally speaking, not physical violence. Although, let's be real, guys. Let's be real. Let's be real about it.
So the Democrats have been better than others, and hopefully in the future they'll be better than they are now. So I have no problem with the generic criticism of Democrats.
Yes. Yeah.
And I don't even care that Jimmy Dore is going on Tucker Carlson's show because Jimmy Dore is, he's an idiot. And most of their, I think, audience is now more or less aligned anyways. But I am amazed at the level of stupidity and the ability to talk about cravenness and to talk about self-enriching without doing your work that this represents. Like, the irony here is just delicious. Jimmy Dore goes on. He knows he's going to get a spike on his YouTube show. I mean, he's doing this for, you know, obviously for publicity. I go on television too, and it is explicitly to have the opportunity to do stuff like I did the other night with David Plouffe, or, you know, and it doesn't happen that often, but that's why I stay doing it. That will never.
See? Jimmy Dore's in it to make himself look good and to promote his show, to make his show look good and all that. Sam Cedar does it because he's fixing the world. That's the difference here.
Never happened on Tucker Carlson's show. And even in this opportunity that Jimmy Dore has to make one slight correction, he doesn't, because he doesn't know anything about what he's talking about.
Well, that's a compliment.
Now, I watched this, at least watched a clip of it, and it's like, I thought Jimmy knocked it out the fucking park. He put both political parties and fucking stapled them to the walls and said, you both fucking suck. You're both warmongers. You both partake in killing innocent people. And that sounds like the most important message to me. But what is Sam going to focus on? Not because of this is some sort of righteous action to correct Jimmy Dore. It's because he probably feels sour that he sucks compared to Jimmy Dore. Jimmy doesn't understand the blah, 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 the logical fallacies of blah, blah, the Democratic Party and the Republican Party. And like, yeah, Sam, you can talk about the schematics of politics. Luke fucking warm. You belong on MSNBC when you do shit like that. When you're talking, oh, the boring nature of politics, as opposed to, this is fucking wrong. The fuck? It's wrong. Someone I would go to battle with, and someone I wouldn't go to battle with.
Well, this is all kind of tied together, because Russiagate is a result of the failure of the Democratic Party to present a platform that gets people who want to vote Democrat off the couch to vote for them. So they can't actually offer them anything because they're beholden to their donors. The same people who control the Republican Party control the Democratic Party. We don't really have
to. Now, I know, without even having to look, that there is probably not one of the hundreds of videos that Jimmy Dore has made this year that talks about, like, the restoration of the Voting Rights Act or, I don't know, paid family leave or, yeah. I mean, much of it is not as far as I want them to go, but it is, in fact, more than is being offered by the Republican Party. But
remember, one less concentration camp guy. So he'll accept that. Here's crumbs. Here you go. It's better than nothing. Both Sam Cedar and Jimmy Dore have the image of being in the realm of politics, right? But one's clearly, it seems like, one clearly has some form of a metaphysical backbone or a righteous crusade they're on. You know, CARE. It's called CARE, I think. Something like that. Right? And the other, they're working with the cold, dead version of life, which is okay. I've done that work. I think it's important work to do the cold, melodic fucking shit you gotta do, right? But he didn't bring his heart with him, though. That's why this sounds like someone struggling. Someone saying, hey, they're fucking killing kids over here. You're like, Jimmy? Did you study the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau? Did you study that? I did. It's like, what? What? I bet Sam couldn't tell me his favorite color. It might be a struggle. He could tell me about the Consumer Financial Bureau, whatever the fuck it is, but he can't even tell me his favorite color. It's like, hey, why do you do what you do, Sam? oh, ah, ooh. He'd sound like a caveman. Let's continue.
Let's leave that there. That's just low-hanging fruit.
The Democratic Party, we don't...
You're low-hanging fruit. Seriously. I don't do that many videos on Sam Cedar, and it's just a cakewalk every time. Probably because he's not a creeper, right? I don't think he's a creeper at all, which is why it seems like I can see his psychology played out right in front of me, right? Because there's no bullshit filter in front of it. I'm the nice suit guy, and I make sure all my words are correct and all of that, and I have a team of PR reps and all that. That's what creepers have, because they know they're invested into nothing. He doesn't realize he's swimming through air. It's like, hey, Sam, there's nothing here, bro. Hey, man.
Don't True. Really have two parties, right? So they have to do Russiagate and impeachment and all these sides, these circus shows, right? So distract you from the fact that the Democratic Party doesn't represent workers anymore, that they actually represent big pharma, health insurance, the military industrial complex, and Wall Street. And that's why all this is happening. And that's why they have to cheat Bernie Sanders, because he's going to upset their game, their money game. And that's why they got to stop him before. The first job of the Democratic Party is to stop the candidate who represents the workers, and then and only then can they turn their attention towards Donald Trump.
Now, pause it for one second. Bernie Sanders got a lot of votes from members of the Democratic Party.
He did, yeah.
I just want to say.
And if he... some linguistic slippage, I think. And...
Once again, we know who... If you've been paying attention to Jimmy Dore, you understand who he's talking about. So I guess the kids would call this a straw man.
Who people are talking about, who different people are talking about.
Exactly. Oh. I mean, that's exactly my point, is that there's...
What'd you say? I want to hear it.
I just want to say. And if
some linguistic slippage, I think, in who people are talking about, who different people are talking about.
Exactly. I mean, that's exactly my point, is that there's absolutely no
point?
Care when you are a talk show host going on a major platform. Your language, you should be thinking about what is actually coming out of your mouth, because nobody can see into your dark, dark, decrepit heart. But go ahead.
Donald Trump.
So what?
Maybe is that why we never have debates about the tax code? We spend a lot of time on bathrooms. We spend a lot of time on these kind of peripheral social issues. But I can't remember the last time someone talked about carried interest. Can you? Tucker, as Nancy Pelosi...
All right, now pause it. And we're going to go back. But I want to tell you something right now, and I say this with more assuredness than anything I think I've said in any recent past. Jimmy Dore has no idea what the carried interest
the carried interest.
Now, maybe he went home and thought, I should really know what that is that Tucker brings up on television. But the idea, first of all, that no one's had a debate about the tax code in this,
yeah.
Like, the Republicans just passed the tax bill,
yeah.
That literally paid that. I think, what was it that Chase, that Jamie Dimon's outfit was bragging about? They made like $3.2 billion.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't even know what the numbers are. Maybe it was more than that.
And the Democrats voted against it.
Every single one of the Democrats voted against it.
They talked about it a lot, and they voted against it. And it was like, also, it ended up being the very first unpopular tax cut.
In the history, right, exactly. I can't remember when somebody did. Now, but he's talking, to be fair, specifically about the carried interest loophole. Let's just play this out a little bit, because... there's a reason why Tucker doesn't remember, and there's also a reason why Jimmy Dore doesn't. And the reason why Tucker doesn't remember is because Tucker's just a propagandist.
Yeah.
And a liar. Jimmy doesn't remember because he's an effing idiot. All right, go ahead.
See? You have to know whatever the fuck they're talking about in order... Otherwise, you're dumb. But... if you're fucking bleeding heart on TV, screaming about the corruption that you see all over the fucking place, it's like, that means nothing. Because he needs to win against Jimmy Dore. And Jimmy Dore ignores him. Right? He's not... Steven Crowder running from Sam Cedar. He's ignoring Sam Cedar. In fact, that's what I think would happen when Jimmy edited out his name. It's like, I want nothing to do with this guy. Let's continue.
Party is to stop the candidate who represents the workers, and then and only then can they turn their attention towards Donald Trump.
So is that why we never have debates about the tax code? We spend a lot of time on bathrooms. We spend a lot of time on these kind of peripheral social issues. But I can't remember the last time someone talked about carried interest. Can you?
Tucker, as Nancy Pelosi is ripping up Donald Trump's speech, she's passing his legislative agenda. So, and also, if you watched closely last night, you got to see her applaud Donald Trump's imperialism when it comes vis-a-vis Venezuela, right? So, and I know you did good work on Venezuela. We all know these foreign entanglements are just CIA plots that steal resources and give it to American corporations. They admitted so much. John Bolton admitted on Fox News that that's what Venezuela was. So you saw the one-party rule last night. You saw Nancy Pelosi applauding and getting up with Juan Guaido, who is a CIA-appointed puppet leader of the Venezuela. So you saw that's the part I like to call out. That's when they're both in bed with the intelligence community. They're both in bed with the military-industrial complex. And that was, and so, yeah, you're right. We're not talking about real things. No. We're talking about Russia.
We're talking about
a phone to the Ukraine. We're never going to talk about why wouldn't the Democrats had complete control of the government? They gave us a right-wing healthcare plan anyway. Oh, maybe it's because there aren't really two parties. There's one party in America, and they're both controlled by big business.
All right.
Jimmy, no.
So
Cedar can't do that right there. He could someday. He can't do that. I really don't think he could. You know, fucking HS Max going to send me, but Sam did this. Look at this clip I sent you. It's like, sorry. If you walk it back at all, like it just turns into, once again, bucket of lukewarm tap water.
Jimmy Dore! Now,
I missed whatever John Bolton appearance in which he said the CIA does coups for resources.
I think he did say something to that effect. But,
all right.
but I think, I am glad that there's that criticism of Guaido and Venezuela and Nancy Pelosi for doing that.
Yeah, that's cool, you know.
You can go up there and say,
cool.
Actually, no, I do know what the carried interest tax is. It's
yeah, you know, the coup in Venezuela, you know, people dying, death squads, and blah, blah, blah. But the codes, the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, you need to define that first. Then you can talk about people being maimed and killed. It's like, you're not even you're evaporated, lukewarm tap water. Just air, fucking water particles in the air and shit. Fucking empty.
When hedge funders basically are allowed to pretend that they somehow they're getting a capital gains tax rate based upon money that they don't even own, essentially.
Oh my God.
It's money that they're getting paid. But
I'm smart, right? I'm smart.
Gosh, why don't the Democrats do anything? Like, who can remember the last time that happened? Do you have the screen grab of when Tammy Baldwin?
Are you doing the thing that you just made fun of Jimmy Dore for? Of the my notes. Sorry, he made fun of it, so. Look at the dude on the left. It's like, it should be him drinking like Lipton iced tea.
Introduced the bill that is, here it is. Tammy Baldwin, a Democrat from Wisconsin, and Bill Parcells from New Jersey reintroduced.
Bill Parcells.
Yeah. Because it was introduced by Democrats. The Carried Interest Fairness Act on Wednesday. This was just 8 months ago, no, maybe 11 months ago, 10 months ago. Who can remember the last time the Democrats did that?
Talked about the carried, yeah, right.
Now, if you ask me, that doesn't mean anything. Because, once again, I believe Jimmy Dore is placing this into a moral question, and Sam Seder is placing this into a lukewarm, dead, strategic, empty, evaporated bucket. That's what I think's happening here. Right? It's like, Bernie can talk about all the, you know, Medicare for alls and free colleges and all that shit. But if he's still shooting kids' faces off in the Middle East somewhere, or in South America somewhere, it's like, I don't give a shit that you fucking did some sort of bill, or you know, he got free subway rides for everyone. I don't care about that. If you're still killing people, your word means nothing. Your policy means nothing. If we like your policy, we'll kick you to the fucking curb and take your policy. Like, it's ours now. You haven't earned it. You can sweep the floors of the subway station. Sweep that for 10 years, then come back to us and tell us what you learned. Fuck out of here, son. But Cedar doesn't have the intestinal fortitude to be in that lane. To be in the moral fight. Right? He's not in that lane.
If Jimmy,
he's doing a job,
would do 5 minutes worth of homework. That
he's doing his occupation.
Like, you know, him just reading Glenn Greenwald's tweets. And actually, like, cared about this stuff that he pretends to care about. He would know what the carried interest is, because Democrats have been talking about it forever. I asked you before the show. I said, can you name me the top three things that Democrats say when they talk about taxes?
The second one I mentioned.
And it was the second one.
I said, like,
one.
The top marginal rate carried interest. Like, yeah, this is exactly. What...
This is, like, basic, you know...
But, so, right, if he actually knew what he was talking about...
You want to know what's even more basic? Your conscience. That's the basic of basic. That's human level basic. Start there, Sam. And then start arguing for things. Using that thing, the conscience. Not your fucking ego on loop because you want to be bigger than Jimmy Dore.
And was not just like vamping, essentially. He, like, the. We know because Tucker is a just. Sort of blunt propaganda, so the premise of his question was inherently silly, because the idea, when he says, you know, why are we always talking about bathrooms? It's like, because you are always talking about
exactly.
Bathrooms.
Exactly. Exactly.
Like,
exactly.
The premise that...
It wasn't like the Obama, Obama said, like, we're going to run on bathrooms.
We're going to run on bathrooms.
No, it's because you and your friends...
Keep talking
make
about
it, like,
it.
The most important issue.
Like, that's the thing you guys want to talk about constantly. Democrats, like... It's not even true to say Democrats wanted to do impeachment to distract from their platform. They wanted to pass a health care bill. Like, they wanted to pass a drug prices bill, I mean.
Go look at Sherry Booth.
They wanted impeachment for what? Health care? What do you say? Prescription?
From their platform. They wanted to pass
it
a health.
The
they wanted to pass a health care bill, like it, they wanted to pass a drug prices bill. I mean,
go
drug
look price. At Sherry Busta.
That was the impeachment thing. So it isn't about corruption. And he might have to explain that to me, because these strategist type guys. It's like, I don't know. I thought it was someone did something wrong, or someone you know dishonorable or something. That's when you say, okay, this guy's got to go. He's corrupt, or at least like we have the feeling he's corrupt because he did something shitty here, something really shitty here. That's why we get rid of him, because of moral reasons. That's what I thought it was supposed to be.
So who we cannot stand.
Yeah.
And everything she was saying, like, the American public's not paying attention to all the things we're passing.
Yeah.
And we don't want to do impeachment.
We don't want to, like, stop.
Like, it's a complete false
complete
narrative.
Fantasy land.
I was calling for impeachment far more than Nancy Pelosi ever even remotely wanted to do.
Yeah.
And, I mean.
For what, Sam? Please tell me for what.
Many people were. And the point being that it's like it's a complete distortion.
I was too.
And, you know, there are people, you know, what was it, Walter Bregman? Was that, who's that guy that?
Rutger Bregman.
Rutger Bregman, who went on there, you know, because he was mocking people at Davos about taxes. Yeah. And he basically said, I'm going to burn this bridge.
Yeah.
But for these people who complain about media figures selling themselves out,
yeah,
I've got to keep going on Tucker Carlson.
Well, that's the entire...
It's either my ignorance or I'm not going to say anything.
That's the whole...
Or he just sounds exactly like Jimmy Dore always sounds. you could see the little gerbil in his brain running on the fucking wheel. It's like, this is all you got, man? It's like, Cedar, you only look good when you're going against Steven Crowder or someone like that, Charlie Kirk or Ben Shapiro or something like that. You don't look so well when you stand next to someone who's seems like, or at least I believe most of the audience would recognize, like, oh, he's using his conscience. Like, he's angry because someone's doing something wrong. Like, oh, and he seems to be focusing on the right wrong stuff that's happening. Like, you know, just straight up killing. That would be seem like the number one thing you look at first. The universally known bad thing is murder or killing, mass killing. So that's why you look stupid right now.
Whole debate about going on Fox, and it's like, should Bernie Sanders go on Fox? Should so-and-so go on Fox? It's like,
and your towel boy looks shitty too, whoever this fucking dude is. See, I can, if I were to talk to these two guys at the same time or separate, whatever, be like, I'll bring you to a realm of ideas you have never asked yourself or you've seen and ran from. And it's like, it would be unfair. Seriously, it'd be seriously unfair. But you can't tell me about the Consumer Financial Bureau. You can't tell me about tax credits. It's like, what? No, let's go over here into morality. Let's go into moral philosophy. Let's see where you land at. Let's see you intellectualize your way out of this.
Like Bernie Sanders goes on, he doesn't like challenge the host, but he goes on to deliver his message that he delivers in every other platform and every other environment. But like, that
host
is self-promotional.
You're going to turn America into Venezuela. He would be like,
that's
whoa.
That's what he's doing on there.
What's that?
Well, I mean, that's right.
That he's using the platform to deliver his message,
which is just full of shit, right?
Which is allow right-wing propaganda to flourish and absolutely distort the reality.
I mean, I'm of two minds.
Whoever this chick is, it's like she's gonna Joe Rogan them. Watch that. She's going to Joe Rogan them by just making like simple observations. And they're going to be like, and watch the scramble. It looks like fucking 49ers versus Chiefs and the ball got loose. Someone fumbled and just watched the scrambling. Everyone tripping over themselves to pick up the fucking football.
I mean, that's right.
That he's using the platform to deliver his message,
which is just full of shit, right?
Which is allow right-wing propaganda to flourish and absolutely distort the reality.
I mean, I'm of two minds.
How? He jumped over Tucker's question and went right to both sides, stood up and clapped for regime change in Venezuela. On national TV during the president's biggest speech moment thingy, State of the Union.
and absolutely distort the reality.
I mean, I'm of two minds about this because I don't believe that Jimmy Dore has a deep analysis. I don't think he has a real class analysis or an analysis of capitalism.
He hasn't read anything.
But
he hasn't read. It's not a question whether he has a deep.
See? You don't have to because he's using his conscience. I do videos called Dumb Guy Logic, which is simple. When you say, oh, okay, here's the incident, and it's some dude slapping some woman in the face. You just use dumb guy like, huh, that doesn't seem right. You shouldn't be hitting anyone. Well, what happened in the scenario? And then that leads to the answer. Just dumb guy logic, like, fuck, I better go read a book on the physics of hands slapping faces. I'll also study biomechanics of male frames versus female frames. I'll also study this and that, but just dumb guy logic can just look at that and be like, okay, that's wrong. Now, what led to that scenario? Read a book. Like I said, me with no books would stomp mud holes in both of these motherfuckers pretty easily. In fact, they probably cower because I'm a black dude. But, oh, in their mind, they're playing mental gymnastics about identity politics. Like, oh, what do I say here? I can't say this. They're cutting themselves off already. I'm watching their neurons fizzle out. You're like, I can't go down that track. That might sound too much like this. And
deep or class analysis. This is just the news. Like, if you're complaining that the Democrats don't look at taxes and you don't know that they have argued against the, which is, granted, very low-hanging fruit. Yeah. It's not a big bar. But you don't know that, then you don't know shit.
Sure, but some of the things he's saying are valid critiques.
Which is exactly what I said. But it's useless because he is allowing a narrative that is that makes it impossible. It's disempowering. Because if you think that the Democrats are not doing anything, then what's the point? What army is going to stop from doing it?
At the fundamental.
Well, he's saying, I thought Dore was saying, both sides are bought and paid for. Meaning they all got to go. And I agree with that. What's Sam's opinion? If his opinion is we can't make that happen, so we have to deal with what we deal with. But then Dore's right to say they're all bought and paid for. Right? If Sam Cedar agrees, like, oh, these guys suck and we'd probably be better off with, you know, a whole new mix of people. Yeah, he might actually believe that. Yeah, he might be, dick ride the squad because, well, they won over those other Democrats we don't like as much. We like them more than Republicans, but we're trading off evils here. in the moral philosophical realm, he would be a mental midget. Seriously. And I can say this. And what will happen? I don't know.
At a level too, like the debate they're having is like do they understand that Bernie Sanders is running for the Democratic nomination?
Exactly.
The person who they are. Like, why do the Democrats?
People can't tell that when Jimmy Dore's talking about one person, it's almost like Jimmy just mentioned Bernie Sanders in the video, and said they're working against Bernie Sanders. That's almost like a actual assessment that's actually happening. It's almost like in the Iowa caucuses, they're actually shaving votes and rounding errors with delegates or with whatever it is, special delegate equivalents, whatever the fuck it is. So.
Democrats never want to talk about anything important. Like,
he's a Democrat. He's running for the Democratic nomination.
The Democrat who wants to talk about that stuff all the time.
So you can't say anything bad about these other guys. Because he's in their party, and it's a giant team. It's either the whole team or nothing.
Is in first place.
Exactly. Why isn't he in the Republican Party? Why isn't he running as a Green candidate? I mean,
yeah, exactly.
It is designed.
That's what Jimmy wants him to do. But Bernie probably could run as an independent. I believe he was an independent for many years. and he probably could run as an independent, but he realizes the game is fixed for two fucking parties. Maybe Sam doesn't realize that. Maybe he didn't find it in one of his books that he's reading.
To disinvest people from the political process, from anything meaningful, by basically saying it's all shit, there's nothing involved here that's relevant.
I don't know. I'm of two minds.
I thought he was saying these guys will actively fight against someone who means well, means to do well, that's not going to, you know, bend over and do the corrupt thing. He said, I thought he was just making an analysis of that. Not, you know, all right, everybody, give up. Just give up. It's useless.
Minds about it.
I know you said that, but my point is, like, I
she might get fired after this.
Gave him credit for what he said about
Guaido.
I'm joking. But the point is that he's basically saying
he'd have to wait a little
answer.
Bit first.
I give him credit for some of the critiques he's making of the Democratic Party as well. Like, it has, as an institution, historically been very resistant to any kind of left populist realignment. I would recommend a piece called It's Their Party in the Jacobin by Paul Heidemann going through the historical case for this.
But Jimmy's not historicizing.
The problem comes in when
you're
in.
But Jimmy's not smart.
Case for this.
But Jimmy's not historicizing.
The problem comes in when you're imposing Carlson and allow this to be weaponized by reactionaries.
Yeah, I mean,
right.
Like, yes, of course. I mean,
the thing is, like, vamping about Venezuela is not a response to the faulty premise that Tucker introduced the question.
Exactly.
With.
Exactly.
See? Like, anything they can get. Anything. This is a desperate, borderline creepy attempt. I'm surprised he left this video up here. This video is fucking long as shit. Whatever.
And this is not a question of, like, protecting the Democratic Party. 90% of what we do here is talk about deficiencies in the Democratic Party.
It's a little PR there. I fight them. I fight them. So, you know, this isn't protection of them. I fight them. Consumer Protection Bureau.
But to go up and essentially just feed into this for money. That's what he's doing it, for his celebrity and money.
Okay. See, you have to lay that out as a, as a precondition so that the rest will now you can create a narrative from there. I say that about these, about people who make these arguments about, genetics and behavior or something, right? You have to start with the premise that we are our brains and that's it. You have to start there. And then the rest is an easy story to make up from there. Now it all makes sense. You can do the opposite route too. You can say, oh, it's all ordained by God. And then I can write a narrative for every event that happens after that. Jimmy Dore is on there for money. So now, anything he says or anything he lets go is just an excuse to make money. All right? He makes money off ranting. And then, see, I can create a narrative from there.
He's not delivering a message to anybody that they're not going to hear from Tucker, which is Democrats just care about transgender bathrooms. Democrats aren't doing anything for you. Republicans may not be doing it. That's Tucker's shtick this week. But beyond that, he's not doing anything.
I could have swore he said both parties, but, you know. And he's talking about shit a lot of people don't know about. He's also saying something that maybe Tucker's audience are not hearing every day. But hey, it's both parties. Hey, it's warmongering Trump. Is Tucker saying that? Is Tucker calling Donald Trump a warmonger?
except for basically driving people to his YouTube show. He's not challenging anything. And he's lying as he does it.
Can I play this thing lying about Alex Jones talking about David Icke?
Yes.
Just get tired of the real
I'm going to skip past this part. It's Alex Jones saying, oh, you know, David Icke is muddying the waters because, oh, you have all this great conspiracy information, and then you throw in, you know, reptilians, and it muddies the waters. It's like, gotcha. I don't see where Jimmy Dore did that here. Because he didn't address the Consumer Financial Bureau. Come on, read a book and know this. Most important knowledge of the universe. Democrats are talking about taxes. Come on. It's like, what? What? Oh, dear God. This dude, he's not part of the solution. He's definitely not part of the solution, the Sam Cedar guy. As far as what I understand as a solution. Right? Conscience comes first. He's not even looking for it.
He discredits it all. It's like a turd in the punch bowl.
And then, you know, what Alex Jones did is he realized, like, that's the way I'm going to make money.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's actually like...
It's completely disempowering. And that is the problem, is that it is completely disempowering.
Yeah.
And is it the venue that primarily pisses you off? Would you be this angry if Noam Chomsky went on Tucker Carlson and said basically that same critique, which he's been making for decades?
No, it's the work, right? Like, we already talked about Bernie.
What?
Look at this. This small little portion here. It will exemplify what I've just been saying this whole time. Listen to her question.
That is the problem, is that it is completely disempowering.
Yeah.
And is it the venue that primarily pisses you off? Would you be this angry if Noam Chomsky went on Tucker Carlson and said basically that same critique, which he's been making for decades?
No, it's the work, right? Like, we already talked about Bernie.
What?
I'm just telling.
Would I have a problem if Noam Chomsky went on? I don't think that Noam Chomsky would let Tucker get away with all those lies. Do you? Do you think Noam Chomsky is so stupid that he doesn't know that the Democrats have a problem with carried interest?
Do you think Noam Chomsky would focus on carried interest? Do you think that would be the main focus when you're talking about the State of the Union right there? I'm sure. I think Noam Chomsky would bring up shit about Tucker Carlson, 100%. But he's not going to talk about that little fucking sentence that he said. But, oh, Tucker, yeah, you've taken money from here. How come you're not celebrating Juan Guaido, too? Oh, we've had numerous past presidents that have, you know, been propping up dictators all over the fucking world. You wouldn't say fucking, but, you know. In fact, I think Chomsky would sound a lot like Jimmy Dore in that interview. A lot like him, except Chomsky would be a lot more, he'd be bringing up probably past shit that Tucker Carlson has done or said. And Sam looks befuddled, but what, you think Noam Chomsky doesn't care about the Consumer Financial Bureau? It's like, yeah, Chomsky probably cares, but, you know, the topic was the State of the Union address.
Not.
Do you think that Noam Chomsky knows a little bit more than Jimmy Dore?
I would say that he
does. So what is? I don't have a problem with him. I said specifically at the beginning of this, I don't care that he goes on Tucker Carlson.
So this is just ego, pride, protection. What? She's like, well, you know, Chomsky might. He said this a lot too. He'd probably say something similar, you know. But what? You think Chomsky? Do you think Chomsky will let that bathroom comment go? Come on. It's like... one of his own co-hosts compared Dore to Chomsky. And he's just livid about that. It's like, what? And then his audience ratioed him.
Right. I said I agreed with what he said about Venezuela. We just spent an hour talking about the problems with the Democratic Party.
Okay.
So no, I wouldn't have a problem if Noam Chomsky went on Tucker Carlson and actually told Tucker Carlson to his face, you're a fucking propagandist. Tucker Carlson, who fucking lied to the country about Iraq, and then would go off and have a cigarette in the back room. I don't give a shit about the Iraqis.
No, fair enough.
Yes. I will also say about that clip of Alex Jones on Trio.
She should have pushed back more. Just to peel back more layers of his psyche. Because that shit got gerbils running everywhere. All right. It was a long, long-ass fucking video. All right, that's it from me. Please subscribe if you like, comment, agree, disagree. Tell me what you think. Is Cedar possessed with pride when it comes to Jimmy Dore? And that's all he sees, and he will look for something. He didn't mention the bathrooms. He didn't push back on the bathrooms comment. But Chomsky might have focused on the Venezuela coup and all that. You think Chomsky would let the bathroom comment go? Come on. Think about it. Come on. The interest rate, man. Fucking A. You tell me. I see a lukewarm bucket of tap water evaporating. Especially if the sun's around. It might evaporate, turn into dust. But tell me what you think. Don't forget to donate. Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. With all that said, give this video a thumbs down. Say you wanna get him. And what?